यत्र योगेश्वरा कृष्णो
यत्र
पार्थो धरा तत्र श्री विजयो भूतिर् ध्रुवा नीतिर् मम। टुडे वी विल
टेक सम
डिफरेंट टॉपिक आउट ऑफ श्रीमद् भगवद् गीता। Srimad Bhagavad Gita was emanated from the lotus lips of Lord Krishna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra in Punjab in India approximately 5000 years before. There are 18 chapters and divided into, there are 700 verses divided into 18 chapters. The battle of Mahabharata was fought for 18 days. The main character, the main warrior, Bhishma Pitama, he fought for 9 days. So, the numerology in Srimad Bhagavad Gita is very important.
18
means 8 plus 1, which means 9. And 9 days the main character fought, which is 9. In your body, there are, our bodies are made of 9 elements. 5 gross elements, fire, air, earth, ether, and which is the 5th one? Anybody? Fire, air, earth, ether.
Water.
So these are the 5. At the top of that there are 3 subtle elements. These are the gross elements. Then in Hindi they call Man, Buddhi and Ahankar. Mind, intellect and ego. At the top of that there is the spirit, Atma, which is the integral part of the Almighty. When we die, the 5 gross elements merge into the 5 gross elements. They stay. So our body stays there. The 3 subtle elements then become the chip in modern computer language. And on that you write the program. We are all programmers and we write program, very fine program, subtle form on a daily basis. And according to the wisdom of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna is seated in the heart of everybody. So he is also writing the program. You write the program as a programmer. He being the divine, he is seated in your heart all the time. He is also writing the program. We are selfish. Most of the time bad things we don't write. Because you are writing this, you are the program, you can delete anything. But he is writing the accurate program. So when we depart from this planet, that chip on which you wrote the program yourself, it has to be authenticated, certified by Lord Krishna. So his program overrides your program. And that is the basis of our reincarnation. Depending upon the total net result, this is called net income, that makes the foundation of my reincarnation. So the number 9 is very important. That is what I am sharing with you.
It's the integral
number. It never changes its form. You can multiply it, you can divide it, you can do anything to this number. It stays 9. 9 times 3, 27, still 9. 9 times 5, 45, still 9. So that is the reminder to us
that
we are the product of 9 elements, and 5 gross elements stays here. The other 3, that is mind, intellect and ego, that is the whole game. So people who understand how to tap these resources, mind, intellect and ego, they are better off. They are at peace. They will be doing all these things, going to office, doing household things, and you know, managing people, interaction with society. But they are peaceful. They are positive. That is the litmus test of their personality.
People who understand
how to tap these three resources, mind, intellect, and ego, they are very positive people. They touch and change the people. They, when they interact with the society, they change the society. Because they have changed, so they change. You give only to others what you have. If you don't have, you can't give. So they have perfected this art, how to tap these resources. And here kicks in the art of meditation. These three elements belong to the meditation. It's the inner journey, inner journey. And meditation is the GPS, which can be used to go inside. Otherwise, and it's the password also. If you don't have the password, you can't open any window. So in order to open the window of your mind and intellect, you've got to have the password. And the password is meditation. Simplest and common definition of meditation is to stay in the present. Stay in the present. And that we don't do. That we don't do. We know it, we don't do. Like here, we are sitting here, right? Physically we are sitting here. Mentally you are here or not? Nobody. You know. You are the best judge. You are the judge, jury, witness, everything yourself. Nobody can judge. But you know whether mentally you are here or not. If you are mentally here, you are the beneficiary. If you are mentally not here, you are losing the point. Physically you are here. Definitely you are here. I can see it. You can see me. While I am talking, am I really focusing on Srimad Bhagavad Gita? Or I am talking something, thinking something else also. So staying in the present is the key of meditation. And it teaches you. You have to practice it. And it is, this is called also mindfulness. That what is happening at a moment, enjoy that moment. But we don't do that. So we suffer. We pay very heavy price. Because most of the time, what we do, we are either in the past, thinking things, bad memories, good memories. Kisi ne kuch keh diya, hum bhoolte hi nahi hai. Jo usne achhi baat hai, woh hum bhool jaate hain. So by doing these things, we are misusing and abusing our memory. The optimum use of human memory is to save the goodness of others and delete the demerits of others. But we do the other way around. We save the demerits of others and we delete the merits of others. Aapne mere saal, 10 saal tak meri badi seva ki, achhi bhalai ki. Every moment you are with me. But one fine morning, it may be a bad day, and you said something. Immediately, people who are not in a mode of meditative mind, they will delete your goodness right instantly. And I will save your bad thing what you told me. And I will be repeating that for the rest of my life. I never expected from you. How can you say that? How can I never expected that you can tell me this thing? So that is a bad use of memory. If you are a spiritual person, the art is to save the goodness of others. That is the optimum use of human memory. But if I am saving the garbage of others, bad things, then I am misusing it, abusing it. How can I be at peace? because I am creating a problem for myself. The same we do for the future. Planning is not bad. We must plan.
We go to office.
We plan everything. If I am the manager, I plan everything. You are the employee, you plan everything, your schedule. Planning is not good. Planning is very good. But there is a way to plan. The end result, this end result, then you should leave a question mark. There should be a question mark. You may not get, you may get. If you get, compliment yourself. If you don't get, don't degrade yourself. So that is a positive way of making planning your future. If we do these things, then we are at peace. If we don't do, we mess up life. We are excited, agitated most of the time. When we step out of the house, we are agitated and excited. If I am driving, I will never give right of way to anybody else. I will think I am the owner of the roads. And I will make people angry. And then the person to whom you excited, he will excite somebody else. So it's a vicious cycle. And it starts with me. So when I leave home, going to office or commuting, and I am at peace, I become selfless. I never think right of way. I just think human beings. So even if it is my right of way, I will give my right of way to you, and you will wave, because I don't know. The window will be closed. You will be complimenting me like that. So you make him at peace, and you are at peace. This is how the miracle of staying at peace works. Bug stays with us. We have to do it. We initiate bad actions and we initiate good actions. Choice is mine, yours, individually. Because on this planet we come individual, we live individual. All these peoples, father, mother, sisters, wife, kids, they stay here. Where are our fathers, forefathers? They disappear. And we are in the same line. So if the journey is solitary, make it qualitative. And the spiritual message of Srimad Bhagavad Gita is to make the creation better before you leave. Because in human form, this is the climax of the evolution. If you believe in the theory of evolution, human, jo sharir hai, this is the climax of the creation. We have 5 senses. And we have the ability, resources, understanding, and commitment to initiate and develop the 6th sense. Jisko Bholenath ki eye kehte hain. And it is here. The eye of wisdom. The eye of divinity. The eye, the focus. So, we are the only creature on this planet who have the potent force of 6 senses. So, if we don't do qualitative work, then we are like 3 senses, 4 senses, animals, trees, birds, we are behaving like that. Human Bhagavad Gita gives you the opportunity and resources and the guidance and the awareness. Come on, there's a better way. This road is better than this. But we don't develop that awareness intentionally or unintentionally, and we continue to walk on that where there is suffering. Suffering. Self-imposed suffering. Sukh, dukh, chinta. These shortcomings of the personality are self-imposed. If you are worried, there is a fear, because the germination point of worry is the fear. You are fearful for something. For something. It may be a job, it may be the boss said something, it may be the my report card is not good, evaluation on which my increment is based, you know. Or people are thinking bad about me, something happened and I am fearful. Or I am doing something bad and I am fearful I may not be caught. I may not be caught. So fear is the basis for worries. And the biggest fear in our life is the fear of death. Yahan marna jaye. Drive karte hain. It is the fear that I should drive carefully, otherwise I will not go home. Right? It is the fear. We don't shoplifting in the message store. It is the fear, because the security is there. It is in place. Everything is being watched. You know you are being watched. So we don't do those things. Right? But the question is, as a human being, if you do those things fearlessly, that is the teaching of Bhagavad Gita. Ek hai mar mar ke jeena. Roz hum marte hain, itna hum fearful hain. Aur ek hai death ka fear. Death is just a transition. It is just a transition. This body has to go. Like most of our resources are spent on the outer body. We don't invest inside, which will go with us. And everybody knows this body will melt away like a candle. It is burning every day, it is burning, becoming short, short, short. And one day it will extinguish. So people who judge others, seeing their body, their color, their height, they are foolish people. Because that is not the way to judge people. It is the inside. Beauty lies inside. Beauty lies inside, not outside. So Bhagavad Gita will give you a very strong feedback that think this way. Think this way. So we started the discussion that there are 18 chapters in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, divided into 18 chapters and 700 verses. The first six chapters, that is called the Yoga of Action, Karma Yoga. 7 to 12, that is called Bhakti Yoga, the Yoga of Devotion. And 13 to 18, that is called Jnana Yoga. Or usme meditation bhi hai, Jnana Yoga mein. So basically there are three pillars of Srimad Bhagavad Gita, but there are four for better understanding, because meditation and yoga is included in Jnana Yoga. So much variety, because in the human being, all of us, there are 7.3 billion people on this planet like you and me. And everybody is different, you know it. Everybody is different. So depending upon the constitutional setup of your body and the state of your mind, Bhagavad Gita gives you a lot of different paths to go on that. If you are emotional, very emotional, bhakti is the best, devotion is the best. But if you are karma yogi, you go and touch people. You do physical seva. For you, karma yoga is the best. The yoga of action is the best. But then there's another category, people who are very intellectual, who read, spend a lot of time in reading and digesting the information. And then they come back in the form of teacher, professor, researchers. That is their development. They are coming through the yoga of jnana. But that is a material example. Jnana, according to Bhagavad Gita, is three questions. That is called jnana. And on those three questions, the whole spirituality is edified. And that is, who am I? Why I am here? What is my mission? And where I will go? Because if you analyze your personality, does not matter how rich I am, does not matter how qualified I am, does not matter how many cars I have, does not matter how many possessions I have, at the end of the day, everything will become zero and I will go empty-handed. Right? Is there any doubt? There is no doubt. Everybody knows. But we don't believe. That is another human paradox. We don't believe it. Otherwise, I will adjust myself. We don't believe. We think we will be forever. Jab dusron ko ho raha hai, aur log mar rahe hain, I am all right. People are sick, others are sick, I am all right. Nursing homes are filled with people, but they are there, I am all right. And with this wrong perception, we continue to live, and one day comes when I become one of them. So the idea is, we are subjected to the same rules. We will become sick, we will become weak, we will become fragile. Because gravitational force will pull you down, whether you do or not. You may be doing a lot of yoga, exercising, going to gym, running, all the time jogging. But one day comes when you cannot get up from the bed. And you have seen a lot of stories. There was a very powerful wrestler, his name was Dara Singh in Punjab. And it is sad information that when he was 80, the mightiest people on this planet, they were scared of him in the field of Khada, jisko kehte. When he became 80, he could not stand up from his bed. This is what happens to the body. But it's not a scary thing. It's just the information, how I use it. So if that is the end result, that everything will be health, wealth, everything will be zeroed out and I will go empty-handed, then I have to reflect back what I am doing. So there comes the jnana of Bhagavad Gita. Who am I? हमें नहीं पता इस चीज का. अगर किसी को पूछा जाए, अगर इफ आई आस्क यू और यू और एनीबॉडी, हु आर यू, व्हाट इज योर बेस्ट आंसर, गिव मी एनीथिंग, शेयर नहीं कर रहे, गिव मी योर बेस्ट आंसर. आई एम आस्किंग हु आर यू.
आई स्टिल डोंट नो, सो आई कैन ओनली से व्हाट आई एम नॉट.
ओके, सो यू नो कि यू आर नॉट वेयर यू आर, राइट? व्हाट इज योर आंसर, हु आर यू? It's a simple question, primary question. Elementary class में ये question है, who are you? We are all professional qualified people and we have spent, we are at the prime time of our life. I mean, this is the second phase of life. Student life is gone, this is the second phase. And the question is, who am I? Do we know it? We don't. अब इससे बड़ी पैराडॉक्स क्या हो सकता है कि वी आर लिविंग, वॉकिंग, टॉकिंग, ईटिंग, स्लीपिंग, इंटरेक्टिंग विद पीपल, गिविंग स्पीचेस, मेकिंग स्केड्यूल्स एंड मैनेजिंग लॉट ऑफ पीपल, बट वी डोंट नो हु एम आई, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड ह्यूमन पैराडॉक्स. So here the jnana of Bhagavad Gita will kick in. Bhagavad Gita will tell you who you are. In chapter 15, verse 15, there is a verse which gives you the information, divine information. First of all, you have to read Bhagavad Gita. But the creator, the Lord Krishna, he is the creator of this creation. When he says something, I should not doubt it. If you have that much conviction, profound conviction, it has to be true. Agar mujhe samajh nahi aati, it is a limitation of my mind. But this has to be true. It's the uncontaminated information being given to me at no cost. So chapter 15, verse 15, it goes like this. Sarvasya chaham haridisan nivishto mattaha samritir jnanam pohanam cha vedai cha sarva irahamev vedyo vedant krilde avidev chaham. I am seated in the heart of everybody. This is the first element. I am the memory, second element. I am the forgetfulness, third element. And if you hold these three elements intuitively in the forefront of your mind, then there is no need to read Vedas, which are four, because this is the juice of Vedas. This is what this verse says. So, here is the divine warranty and divine information that I am seated in the heart of everybody. So now, what does it mean? That means you are divine. This is the answer. Who am I? I am divine. I am the spirit. I am the integral part of the Almighty. And this is not I am making up. I gave you the source of information. And I should believe it now. Right? So let us discuss this little thing, that I am divine. But this is the answer of this question. Who am I? I am divine. I am the integral part of the Almighty. I am the spirit. I am not the body. Right? So this is clear now. So if I am divine, and Lord Krishna says, I have to believe it. And now, with this information that I am divine, then I have to behave like a divine person. We don't. We are selfish. We are jealous. We excite people. We take pride and pleasure in gossip. There are a lot of kitty parties these days. Those are den houses of gossip. Contaminated information is overthrown, overflow in those parties. How can you be divine? And you know it, you are divine. Now who has to correct that? Me, you, everybody, based upon this information. And what are the divine habits? Selflessness, compassion, love. That will come only if I believe and practice that I am divine. But I don't believe. Because there is no evident enforcement. There is no evident punishment. So here comes the second part. Being a programmer. If you are divine and you adjust your daily conduct, fine-tuned conduct based upon this information, then your whole daily day will be a different investment. Agar aap commute kar rahe hain, toh koi standing hai, aap baithe hue ho, so your divinity will compel you to stand up and give the seat. Even at your own discomfort, you may be tired. The whole day it was a bad day. But then you compliment yourself that I am practicing divinity. And if you do these things, anything, if we do on a consistent basis for 6 months, that is our habit. And we are the product of our habits. If you take swimming classes, after 6 months you are a swimmer. You start jogging, after 6 months you are a jogger. No, you don't have to tell. The moment you will walk, people say, yeah, his legs are different. Water will become your best friend if you are a swimmer. If you are not, you are scared to death the moment you touch the water. Water is the water. So, with this information, I am stressing it again and again, that I am divine. And this source information is uncontaminated, coming from the lotus lips of Lord Krishna. I should believe that. So now I have to adjust my daily conduct. The moment I get up, I should adjust, I should remind myself that I am divine. So the first litmus test of divinity is selflessness. अपने लिए भी करो जो भी कर रहा है दूसरों के लिए ज्यादा करो. इन साइंस फिजिक्स यू आर अवेयर ऑफ फिजिक्स राइट. तो देयर इज वन लॉ आई थिंक दिस इज कॉल्ड पार्सन्स लॉ ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ विच द शिप्स फ्लोट द वेट ऑफ द वाटर डिस्प्लेस्ड बाय द वेट ऑफ द शिप मस्ट बी मोर must be more otherwise it will sink. So the weight of the ship must be more and the weight of the water displaced by the ship must be more than the weight of the ship. So what does it mean? So agar aapne bhi is bhavasagar mein tairna hai float karna hai to outreach selflessness extend yourself so that you can float. You can, everything will become your friend. You will levitate. But if you are selfish, you will sink. You will sink. और जो भी आपके साथ साथ घूम रहे होंगे वो भी sink हो जाएंगे. So this is the technique to extend yourself. So जो जिन लोगों का center of gravity in old age शिफ्ट हो जाता है बॉडी का दे बेंड दे वॉक दे टेक ए व्हाट यू कॉल दैट स्टिक एंड वॉक लाइक दिस जस्ट टू एडजस्ट द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी बिकॉज इट हैज शिफ्टेड इट हैज मूव्ड राइट. नाउ दे आर एक्सटेंडिंग यू हैव टू एक्सटेंड योरसेल्फ टू कीप द बैलेंस. बट व्हेन यू आर हेल्दी व्हेन यू आर रिसोर्सफुल व्हेन यू आर यंग vibrant, full of energy. That is the time to extend yourself. Give back to the society. Do volunteer work. Go and touch people. The more you do, the more you levitate. And you become divine. You become divine. Second, how to become divine? Change your eating habits. This information, again we are coming back to the same information that Lord Krishna is seated in your heart and you are divine. Now what does it mean in plain English? You are the temple. You, Lord Krishna is seated here. So I am a temple, moving temple, talking temple, living temple, laughing temple, seeing temple. Jin templo mein hum ghoomte hain, वहां क्या होता है वो भी ईंट पत्थर की बिल्डिंग होती है लेकिन जब मूर्ति की स्थापना हो जाती है तो उसको हम कहते हैं ये मंदिर है. तो अगर लॉर्ड कृष्णा कह रहे हैं कि जो मूर्ति वहां आप ढूंढते हो मैं आपके हृदय में बैठा हुआ हूं तो यू आर द टेम्पल बट डू वी ट्रीट अवर सेल्फ एज टेम्पल नो वी डोंट वी ट्रीट इट एज ए गार्बेज can. We don't have the discipline to in eating. Party में जाते हैं जो कुछ पड़ा होता है हम खा लेते हैं. We have no awareness that I have to create the quality. Quality. Lord Krishna is seated here. I am eating for him, not for myself. Because you are not the body. We are not the body. In chapter 2, Lord Krishna says he made a revolutionary revolution that we are not the bodies, we are living in the bodies. Nainam chindanti shastrani nainam dehati bhavka na chainam kale dhyanta apo na shochati maat. Dehino asmin yatha dehe komaram yavanam jaratata dehantir prapti dhidat tatranam hoti. We are not the bodies. We are living in the bodies. So if this revolutionary information is available, Why don't we adjust? What is wrong with us? So, Bhagavad Gita gives you the awareness. Karna mujhe hai. Bade bade mache mahatma aate hain. Aap dekho. We are all computer based. Whosoever is sitting here. Right? How many emails you get? Profound emails. Brilliant emails of full of jnana. Right? What we do? We pass it on to our friends, families and all that. Do we hold even one? No. No. Because we can't. Our minds are saturated with garbage and there's no space. You have to make the space. Computer may, when the disk is saturated with information, what do you do? You delete things which you don't want. You save which are conducive to your information. Why we don't do on a daily basis with us? We don't do that. We don't delete and save. We are doing, but we are doing the other way around. So other way around ka matlab hai ki I have saved so much dirt in my mind. There is no space. Today is the age of information. Information is being bombarded from all sides, from the rooftops, from the galaxies, from space, from moving stars, from trees, from ecology. So much information is being bombarded. You put on the TV in the morning, brilliant people giving you the sermons, and you are still on your bed. So, in your bedroom, still in pajamas, you are getting brilliant information about spirituality. And then you get up and go to office. Not 1% you are holding that information. It is just a show. Showbiz. What is wrong? And then you look around the way we are living. In our homes. In our society. In our, among our relatives, among our friends. Look at the quality of the people they are living. It was not like that. But my point is, if so much good information is available, it should have the positive effect. People should have changed. But it has gone in the reverse cycle. Despite the best information, the quality of life has diminished because in our mind we don't have the space, we cannot hold, you have to delete, like the computer. So delete the things which you are holding and save only those things which are productive, conducive, full of compassion, empathy. So that is how Bhagavad Gita's information will change you from inside out. You don't have to buy anything. You don't have to pay anybody anything. We come here as a volunteer, we just to change people. Nobody is paid anything. And that should be the spirit. So if you do in your office, in your home, with your kids, it will be a better for everybody. But this dog race, when we go to office, we are such in a hurry. Hurry. Kisi ke paas 5 minutes bhi nahi hote. Wo itna time schedule fit hai. 11 baje ki bus wahan se leni hai, 10 baje ka ye karna. Everything is timed. But for spirituality, zero. We don't put any time. Any time. So if that we are not doing, then we cannot be a spiritual person. We will be suffering. We will be suffering. We will be fearful. There will be a lot of anxiety. And when we go to the doctor for checkup, if he says or she says professionally that you have a high blood pressure, slow down and take this medicine. We start taking the medicine. When Bhagavad Gita says, don't do these things, 1, 2 and 3, there won't be blood pressure for the rest of your life. We don't do that. We believe the doctor and we don't believe the creator who is the doctors of the doctors, Lord Krishna. Unki baat hum nahi mante. Bandho ki baat. This is 20 years he went to college for that medicine, treatment, discipline. Uski baat hum maan lete hain. और जो जिसने सारे डॉक्टर क्रिएट किए हैं उनकी बात हम मानते नहीं है तो ब्लड प्रेशर तो होगा. द सेम इज एप्लीकेबल टू फूड. लुक एट द वे वी गो टू टेंपल. व्हाट यू डू देयर, यू ईट सो मच स्वीट्स, शुगर तो होगी, शुगर तो होगी. उसमें मुझे डॉक्टर से पूछने की बात, इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ टाइम कि कब मैं डॉक्टर के पास जाता. जब भी मैं जाऊंगा, व्हेनेवर आई विल गो, ही विल टेक द ब्लड टेस्ट एंड ही विल एनालाइज इट. सर दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम. एंड देन आई विल स्टे अवे फ्रॉम लड्डूज एंड जलेबी एंड ऑल दैट स्टफ. बट अब नहीं, क्योंकि लॉर्ड कृष्ण कह रहे हैं कि आई एम सीटेड इन यू, थिंक बिफोर व्हाट यू पुट इन योर माउथ. Create the quality. You don't have to prove anybody anything, but prove to yourself. And that is called spirituality. Discipline. Discipline. Okay. Temptation hai, but ab kar nahi rahe. That is called discipline. When the opportunity is there, 100% opportunity is there, and you restrain yourself, because you have trained yourself. Overnight nahi hota. We are the product of our habits. We will continue to do that. But if you have been practicing the control, temptation will evaporate. It will never come. Never come. Nobody has to tell you don't eat this. Because you have disciplined yourself. And there is no question. So, Bhagavad Gita makes you healthy through food. Bhagavad Gita dictates you, give the commandment. Don't do these things. Eat healthy, eat qualitative food, because I am sitting inside you. Treat your body as a temple. जो temple में आप नहीं करते, वो इसके साथ भी ना करो. That is the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita. That is the wisdom of Bhagavad Gita. So we started with this, the knowledge part. What is knowledge according to Bhagavad Gita? I said there are three components. Who am I? So we discussed in its entirety that who am I? I am the integral part of the Almighty Lord Krishna. Having said that, I am divine. Having said that, I am a temple, moving temple. I should behave like that. I should slow down. Reflect the divinity in your daily actions. Daily, daily. Small things. Life is made of small things. Big things come once in a while. Once a while. So daily, on a daily basis, if you are a businessman, you are self-employed businessman, what you do? You do lot of sale. Right? At the end of the day, you have some system to know, did I make money or did I lose money? Chahe aap ek paper pe likhte ho, rudimentary or in the computer. This is my sale, this is my cost. So this much I made. Right? Itna, even if a most illiterate businessman who is self-employed, he is totally ignorant of the technology. He is also aware at the end of the day, did I make money or did I lose money? On our daily basis, we don't do that. We don't take the inventory. Did I do certain divine acts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No. क्यों किया ही नहीं है? All our actions are based on geared to selfless thinking. Selfish thinking booms. Selfless levitate. So this first element is extremely important information coming out of Bhagavad Gita, that I am divine. I have to act in a divine way. My eating habit should be qualitative. This is not a garbage truck where you pour in everything. It is a temple. Lord Krishna, you are eating for Lord Krishna. So now with this awareness, when I will eat, with this information, I will be qualitative. I should not do that. Because there is no evident enforcement and punishment. You are the judge, you are the jury, you are the witness box. You have to do it yourself. Second part, I am the memory. Which means, don't misuse and abuse your memory. Save those things which are worth saving, delete those things which are garbage. Save the goodness of others and delete the demerits of others. You will be at ease. It is simple. It is just a click, like a computer. But do it on a daily basis. Do it on a daily basis as well. We get so many emails these days, right? So if I don't touch the computer and I only sign on in the evening, there may be 500 emails. What do you do? What do you do? You delete. You know, if you don't delete, you don't have the memory now, right? So what you do delete, on a daily basis you are deleting. But we don't do these things on a daily basis with our mind. Our mind is a computer. Do it like that. It is a better way of living. And that is the awareness of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. So we will continue next time on this information, the memory column. Memory, how to use it at the optimum spiritual level, which will be translated in our beautiful personality, holistic personality, cheerful personality. If Lord Krishna is sitting in your heart, I am going to finish it. His other name is Chitragupta. I shared with you. Chitragupta means the person who is taking your picture secretly all the time. Gupta means secretly, Chitra means photographer. He is a videographer. He is taking your picture every moment. Then why don't you laugh? Why we have long faces? Because we don't believe it. If a cameraman comes here and he says, I want to take the group picture, and he does not say to you, smile. What do you do? Even without he saying, you smile. Right? But Lord Krishna is taking your picture all the time. Why do we have long faces? The album of your life will not be that great. You will say, this is not my picture. So, smile. Broad. Bring the glow on your face. Only with this information, that I am being photographed. And I am not making up. He says in chapter 15. So believe Bhagavad Gita. It will change you. This is the source of information. Do you deal in stocks? Anybody dealing in stocks? Yes? So if I give you inside information, is company ka stock level? And you invest, it's the inside information. What happens next day? You are a millionaire. Right? And I am giving you the inside information from coming out of Bhagavad Gita. You do this, spiritually you will be a millionaire. We don't invest. We don't believe. Stock information to hum maan lete. Ye nahi maante. But it will be changed from inside out. People, it is a time-tested technique. Rishis, munis, the brilliant, the most elitist minds, they tested that. And they came up with this conclusion, yes, the information is right. So let us seek the grace of Almighty and start doing these small things on a daily basis. Become the auditor of your daily routine. Audit yourself. Make a balance sheet at the end of the day. Not the balance sheet, then at least the, what you call that, income and expense. Make an even trial balance. Do something, but do it on a daily basis so that next day you are a better person. But if we are living randomly, कि ये भी ठीक है, वो भी ठीक है, who cares? There's only one life to live. Then we are sure to be doomed. We will have suffering, physical, mental, financial. Bhagavad Gita makes you financially independent because your quality will improve. Believe me. Jai Shri Krishna. Next week, Jai Shri Krishna.